So in this video, I want to talk about a small modification that we can make to improve the GAN training. In particular, we are looking at improving stochastic gradient descent for the generator. But yeah, before we get to that, let me highlight or just list some of the problems with GAN training. In a future video, I will show you some tricks and tips for addressing some of the problems, or at least for improving GAN training. But here, let's just take a look at this list of problems. So one problem is the constant oscillation between the generator and discriminator loss. So things never converge, things might just keep oscillating. Another very common problem is mode collapse, which essentially means that the generator will learn how to generate a particular type of data that is particularly good at fooling the discriminator. So that is also one problem. Usually when you see that the generator is only producing one kind of image, then this is usually due to this type of mode collapse, where the generator just exploits a weakness in the discriminator, just producing a particular type of image. One common problem with a traditional or conventional GAN training that I showed you before, or that we discussed when we had this min-max setup, is that the discriminator would be too strong usually, or what can happen is that the discriminator is too strong, which is a common problem, because classification is simpler than generating data. So it can easily be that the discriminator is too strong. And if this happens in the very beginning, that the discriminator starts out very strong and using the loss gradient that I showed you earlier, what happens is that the gradient for the generator will vanish, it will be too small, and the generator can't keep up with the discriminator, and then things won't train at all. Another problem could be that the discriminator is too weak and the generator produces non-realistic images that fool it too easily. So the difference here between one is that the discriminator is too strong and here it's too weak. In practice, it's usually that the discriminator is too strong because classification is easier than data generation. So there is a little trick that we can apply to at least address this problem to some extent, and that is something I will explain in the next couple of slides. Okay, let's now focus in on the problem related to the discriminator being too strong, such that the gradient for the generator vanishes and the generator can't keep up, which can be fixed or at least mitigated as follows. So here what I have is the original GAN formulation that I showed you from the paper earlier, from the algorithm 1 screenshot. And what we had is here the update for the generator. So this is the gradient of the loss with respect to the generator weights. And if you recall, the generator wants the discriminator to output something close to 1 for these generated images. So here these are the generated images, and it wants the discriminator to think they are real. And then if we have something close to 1, then we'll be log 1 minus 1, which will be minus infinity. And this is where we then minimize this loss function. And it is maximized if this is somewhat close to 0, because then we have log 1 minus 0, which is 0, right? So in this case, what we want is something close to 1, but it might happen in the beginning, especially that the output of the discriminator is close to 0, because in the beginning it is kind of hard to generate new images from scratch if the generator hasn't learned anything yet, so in the first few iterations. So in the beginning it will be very easy for the discriminator to tell apart real and fake, so in the beginning it will output something close to 0. This will maximize this loss, and we want to minimize it, so that's actually good. But the problem is that the gradient signal will be relatively small, and it will be kind of hard this way for the generator to learn efficiently. I mean, it will be able to learn, but not very efficiently, because the gradient will be relatively small, and it can be improved, like shown at the bottom. So, but yeah, let me maybe outline the problem first with the gradient here. So what we have is a log 1 minus something, let's call this the inside is a generated image, but let's just call this whole thing x prime, or maybe something like y hat. Let's call that y hat. So what we have is log 1 minus y hat here. What is the derivative of that? So for that, we would need the chain rule. So you know that the derivative of something like log x would be 1 over x. So here we have to use the chain rule, the outer times the inner derivative. So what we have is for, let's do the inner derivative first. So it's 1 minus y hat. So we are looking at the derivative with respect to y hat, of course. So the inner derivative here would be 1 minus, so the derivative of 1 minus y hat would be minus 1, right? Because with respect to y hat, then this vanishes and this becomes a 1. So we have minus 1 times the outer derivative. Like I said before, the outer derivative is as follows. So of log x, it would be 1 over x. So here the outer derivative would be 1 over 1 minus y hat, right? So the derivative then is minus 1, or just let's write it like this, minus 1 1 over y hat. I'm doing prime here, but I mean hat, of course. Okay, so this is our derivative. So if something is close to a zero here, our derivative will be around minus 1 if this is close to 0. And I mean, this is okay, but it's not like the strongest derivative, so it won't be the best, let's say, for learning the generator in the beginning. So a trick is to turn this gradient descent problem into the following gradient ascent problem. So now what I'm doing here is I'm dropping this 1 minus here. So then if the discriminator outputs a 0 here, the loss would be infinity, and if the generator outputs, if the discriminator outputs a 1, which is what we want, the loss would be 0. So now we have the loss between 0 and infinity, and before we had it between minus infinity and 0. So before we wanted to minimize it, so before we wanted to minimize the loss. Now it's gradient ascent, we want to maximize this term. And this will give us here stronger gradients if the initial prediction of the discriminator is that it can detect the generated images. So if in the worst case scenario what we have is that the discriminator outputs something close to a zero, right? And now if you look at this term here, the whole term, it's a log x term, and the derivative of log x is is 1 over x, right? So in the worst case now we have something close to 0, and let's say we have 1 over a very small number, then what will happen is that the gradient will be, derivative will be much larger here for a discriminator that can successfully detect the generated images. So here, using this formulation at the bottom, the generator will burn more effectively in the beginning. Yeah, so by now we have seen a lot of gradient ascent and descent and flipping between the two and so forth. So it might look super complicated, but in practice actually it's not as complicated as you might think. It's actually pretty straightforward to implement the GAN loss function with regular gradient descent. So we will be using regular gradient descent for both the discriminator and the generator, and it will probably be more clear when you see that implemented in code in the next video. But let me briefly just finish the section on this trick, or just in general how we can turn everything into a gradient descent problem. So in an earlier video on the original GAN, we have seen in the paper that they mentioned gradient ascent for training the discriminator. So previously in the paper they mentioned that they are maximizing the prediction probability of classifying real as real and fake as fake for the discriminator. But as you remember from the logistic regression lecture, long time ago, lecture 8 I think, what we said is that maximizing the log likelihood is the same as minimizing the negative log likelihood. So the negative log likelihood, we can also think of it as the cross entropy. So in that way we can actually just use our regular cross entropy, binary cross entropy in PyTorch to optimize the discriminator. We don't have to do gradient ascent. So the same for the generator. So for the generator, we first, in the original paper, they first said it's about minimizing the likelihood of the discriminator making correct predictions. And minimizing the likelihood is the same as maximizing the cross entropy in that sense. It's similar to here maximizing the log likelihood and minimizing the cross entropy. Here it's now flipped, minimizing likelihood and maximizing cross entropy. But we just talked in the previous slide that this is actually not ideal because the gradient, small gradient issues. So we said that it doesn't work well in practice because of these small gradient issues. So what we did is we flipped, or we didn't flip, but we modified the loss first so that we can use gradient ascent. But in practice, it's even better to just flip the labels and minimize the cross entropy. So what we are doing is we are forcing the discriminator to output high probabilities for a real image if an image is fake. So a higher probability for the real label given that the image is fake. If this all is very dense and complicated here on the slide, there's a lot of information here, let me go through the next couple of slides where I will disentangle this a little bit. There are only two more slides, and then we will see a code example. And in the code example, you will see it's actually pretty straightforward. Okay, so now I will just step by step illustrate how everything relates back to our binary cross entropy or minimizing the negative log likelihood. So here, this is the gradient ascent step from the original paper, from the GAN paper. So again, this is for the discriminator, and we want the discriminator for the real images to output something close to one here. And on the right hand side, for the fake images, we want to output something close to zero. So this is the original GAN objective for the discriminator, and it's with a gradient ascent described in the paper, but we can turn this into a gradient descent problem by just using our negative log likelihood function, the loss function that we have seen from the logistic regression lecture. So here, this whole thing is, I just used that from the logistic regression lecture. This is our loss function we used there. And here I'm just highlighting how the GAN objective maps to this loss function. So again, we had these two parts. We had the minus y, and then we had minus 1 minus y. So let's just focus on the y here. So if the true label is 1, then we use this term, right? And if the true label is 1 here also, then this will become 0, so we don't do anything with this one. So if the true label is 1, we don't do anything with the right-hand side. We only do something with the left-hand side. If the true label, if the class label is 0, then this whole thing will become 0. So we don't use this one, and this one becomes 0, so 1 minus 0, this one becomes 1. So we are using only this right part if the class label is 0. So there are these two parts to the loss function. This is just from the logistic regression lecture. So now let's focus on this part here, right? So we want this to be close to 1, and this is for the real images. And we said for the real images, we have class label 1. So for the real images, we are looking at this part here. And we want the prediction also to be close to 1. So that is how our objective maps here to a gradient descent problem, because here we have also the minus for the negative log likelihood. This is a negative log likelihood. We have minus and minus. So we are minimizing, we're trying to minimize this term, right? And for fake images, we are looking now at the right-hand side, right? Because for fake images, we have the label 0, so this will become 0, cancel, so the whole thing will cancel. We only look at the right-hand side here. So then this one will be 1, and then we look at log 1 minus y hat. So again, we have a negative log likelihood. It's a minimization here, so we want to, when we do the gradient descent, what happens, we will learn how to output a y hat here. This is the ideal case. This is what minimizes our loss here, right? Because otherwise, minus, if this would be a 1, then the whole thing will be, the whole thing will become 0 and minus log of 0 will be minus minus infinity. It will be infinity, right? So this is highlighting how this one, the gradient ascent, becomes a gradient descent in practice when we use our negative log likelihood. Yeah, let's now look at the generator objective. So at the top, this is from the original paper, the gradient descent part of the original GAN paper. And we can also, yeah, transfer this to our negative log likelihood context. So because now we are having the fake images from the generator, so we have the fake labels, which are zero. So this part is zero, so this whole thing cancels. We can ignore this part, only focusing on the right-hand part. But if we use a regular negative likelihood, if we optimize this, what will happen? It will wants to optimize the prediction to zero, right? However, we want the opposite. We want to fool the discriminator, right? We don't want to encourage it to detect the fake images. We want to fool it so that it thinks these are real. So how can we do that? We can flip this sign here to a positive sign. So then instead of this being maximized to y hat 0, it will be maximized to y hat equals 1. Okay, so but we set, actually this is bad because flipping the sign, it will correctly achieve our objective, but the gradients will be very small if our discriminator is successful in predicting that the generated images are generated. So we said, okay, this is actually not a good idea. We want to modify this loss function where we don't have the one minus here, right? So that is what we spent a couple of minutes about talking in the previous slides. So what we can do instead of modifying this label, instead of modifying this sign here to a plus sign, instead of doing that, we can just flip the labels. So flipping the labels. So instead of doing the gradient descent before, so before we had this gradient descent here with this one minus, and we said this is bad, so we are removing the one minus here, and we do a gradient ascent, and we can just flip the labels to turn this into a gradient descent problem. Okay, so the modified loss function now is, or what we are doing is, we have usually for the fake images, we have the label 0, right? Now we are flipping this. Now instead of using label 0, we are using label 1 for the fake images. This is for the generator. And then we can use this part of the loss function, because yeah, this one will be 1, this one will be 1 here. So this whole thing cancels. And we are looking at this one. And then what will happen is, if we have a 1, it will also try the prediction to make it similar to the 1. And then because we provide it as 1, but in reality it's actually still the 0, I mean it's a fake image, what will happen is that the discriminator will be trained to make the wrong prediction. So the generator trains to fool the discriminator to make wrong predictions. Okay, so this was probably super complicated, lots of stuff happening. So in the next video I will show you a code example, and you will see we are just using regular binary cross entropy for everything, and the regular stochastic gradient descent or ADAM optimizer, and it will be pretty clear then afterwards, I hope.